Hi there, it's Ron Gula. Today we are going to discuss how the NIST Cybersecurity Framework can be used to protect small business. Gula Tech Adventures invests in companies and nonprofits that help protect the nation's cyberspace. And I'm creating this series of videos that shares my long experience working at the NSA, running companies like Tenable Network Security, and investing in several dozen cybersecurity startups. So today we're going to talk about the NIST Cybersecurity Framework. NIST is the National Institute of Standards and Technology. A little bit more than a decade ago, they came out with something called the NIST Cybersecurity Framework, which was a way to simplify and understanding the complexities of cybersecurity. Those are five basic areas that they broke everything up to. First is identify what you need to protect. Protect it, detect when those protections fail, respond to those intrusions, and then recover and get back to normal business. Now, you might not think that as a small business this applies to you, but it really does. Let's start talking about identifying what IT assets you have. Anything in your small business that's connected to the internet, connected to another computer, connected to a partner, even things that are not yours, such as personal employee devices that might connect to your network and your data, are all things you need to think about protecting. You can't protect something what you don't know. Try to make a list of everything that your business uses and touches from an IT point of view, and I'm sure you're going to have a lot of surprises on there. The second thing you need to think about is how you should be protecting those. You know, for a typical Windows computer, we want to patch it, we want to put antivirus on it, we want to make sure when we log on there's a strong password. But when you start thinking about the cloud, applications, email, perhaps a payroll system, perhaps an alarm system that you use to protect your physical location of your business, those are all things that have different levels of access control and risk for who should be getting to them. Protecting is not just about patching an antivirus. It could be putting two-factor authentication on. It could be limiting the number of users in your organization who has access to those things. It could be even taking computers that are on the internet and disconnecting them from the internet. Now, once you protect a set of IT assets, you need to think about monitoring them for when those protections fail. Now, this can be a little bit interesting. We all have security cameras, but we don't sit there and usually watch, you know, the alerts for when those security cameras are there. And IT systems produce a lot of data. There are companies out here that can monitor your systems for you. They can monitor your systems for evidence of intrusions. And there's even products that you can do here. The point is you need to think about how your IT systems can be compromised and what you can do to figure out when those compromises are perhaps in progress or perhaps they've already occurred. Once you find these intrusions into your network, you need to figure out how to respond to them. Now, responding is much more than just finding the hackers or finding a malicious employee and taking care of that. It could be deciding who to tell within your company. Perhaps who should be talking to the media, who should be talking to your customers and partners. Some attacks will get publicized and you might have a public relations issue on your hand. Having policies in place within your organization, even if you're just an organization of two, can really make it easier to respond when these things occur. And finally, trying to get back after an attack has occurred to normal business is recovery. You might have to rebuild laptops. You might have to have alternate forms of communication during an actual attack. You might have to be working with the FBI and trying to, you know, chase Russian or Chinese hackers while you're doing this. Once you're done with that, though, you have to recover and get back to business as normal. So those five areas comprise the majority of the NIST Cybersecurity Framework. There's a lot more detail that I'll refer you to by reading the framework, but for small business, I want to give you a couple tips. The first thing is whatever your answers are to these issues, 1 through 5, how do you identify things, how do you protect things, and so on, you should not keep it a secret. You should involve as much of your employees as appropriate so you can have the most comprehensive answers to which IT systems you have, how you should protect them, how you should recover, and so on. You need to simulate the attacks that you think are most likely. Simulation can be a paper exercise, it can be a thought exercise, it can be as simple as doing a lunch and learn and asking your employees, what would happen if we got locked out of our payroll system? How do we recover that? What would happen if this building had a fire? What would happen if We didn't lose, we have lost internet for a couple days from a denial of service attack. These things need to be asked, and how you respond to them needs to be discussed ahead of time. The more you can involve your employees in these discussions and these decisions, the better off you're going to be doing. And this is also an opportunity for you to reward employee behavior. If you have employees whose primary responsibility is not IT, yet they are coming up with great ideas for how to minimize risk and protecting IT assets, it's a good opportunity to give bonuses and recognition and try to build that culture that too often we don't buy in, because cybersecurity tends to be somebody else's problem and not everyone's problem. And finally, the more you do this, you might be thinking, wow, this is going to be expensive. I got to pay somebody to watch my systems or buy some software. The more you do this and the more you think about it, the more you have an opportunity to simplify how you are doing the entire NIST cybersecurity framework. You might be able to consolidate vendors. You might be able to actually make some technology decisions that makes your network much easier to defend. Now, thanks for watching today. If this video was interesting, we have a lot more to share at gula.tech. Our entire portfolio of cybersecurity startups, all the winners of our Gula Tech Foundation cybersecurity nonprofits, and 5 years worth of blogs and videos where we discuss topics like this. Good luck protecting your small business with the NIST Cybersecurity Framework.